recipe that she'll be able to use on her barbecue. It's Rob Rainford, everyone. Give him a big hand. Nice prize, eh?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, my dear.
Good to see you.
Good to see you again.
Between you and Mike Holmes, you've lost about one person.
A whole person, yes.
A whole person.
You look at the book. If you hold up the book, that's 233.
Yeah.
And this is 195-ish or something like that.
Yeah,
so
it's amazing.
Happy.
That's great.
Happy.
So you know what? Part of that is probably grilling. If
yes.
you just eat grilled food, you're in a good place diet-wise.
And some salads, okay? Remember the green stuff, okay?
Yeah.
Green stuff. Oh, well, you're going to help me because I've started some of the work for you. You're going to make my slaw,
all right?
My slaw consists of a little carrot, and this is some cabbage, okay?
Okay.
Some green onion, some parsley over there, salt, pepper, olive oil. Don't dump all of these ingredients. No.
Okay.
You can dump all those guys, but dump very little of everything else. Just a little bit of a marinade.
All right.
Actually, you know what? I'll help you create the marinade, okay?
So this is a bit of a... See, he doesn't trust me. This
no,
is
I trust
a recipe.
You. I trust you. I've been here before. You know I trust you. Come on now.
This is a recipe for Dad as well. Listen, Mom's going to love it too, obviously.
Yes. Well, it's for Mom. It's just, Dad's going to cook it, but Mom's going to love it. All right.
That's the way I was thinking Father's Day. The man likes the barbecue usually in a lot of homes. He might want to have some barbecued ribs because that's what we're making, short ribs. Right.
But see, look, I just made your dressing for you. It emulsified nice and quickly.
That's beautiful. That.
And you pour that over top.
Okay.
And remember, there's a little bit of salt here.
Yeah.
And just a touch of sugar, which if you can, I'll reach for the sugar. And I'll
we'll
do that.
That.
And remember, it always tastes better from coming up high, okay?
Okay.
Absolutely. All right. So you're doing
salt.
That for me.
Okay.
All right. I've got my short ribs that are on already.
Yeah, they smell
these guys,
really good.
And they cook in no time at all. So let's backtrack a little bit. I've got some short ribs on this side.
Yeah. Now,
all right. So these guys, they come nice, quick, easy to do. This is what they look like. And we jump it into a little bit of a marinade, okay?
Do you want to help us out at all with the selection of the meat? Like, does it matter what you're going for?
I think so. You know, quick and easy is the way to go for most people.
Yeah.
And when you come home from work, and even on Father's Day, when you don't want to be out there forever either, right?
Right.
You want to be out there. You want to get back in and want to enjoy the family. If you want to watch a little TV afterwards or whatever, go out for something, you do what you got to do. All right. So I've got some interesting ingredients, a little paprika, smoked paprika, some cayenne, some cumin, a little bit of oregano. And all I'm doing right now is this can stay in a marinade for anywhere up to a day.
Yeah.
All right? As long as you don't have any vinegars in there.
Mm-hmm.
Or if it's a lot of oils, an hour and a half.
Okay.
Perfect, okay?
All right.
All right, so we have our short rib here. These guys, this is the amount of time it actually took to cook.
So nice and thin is going to make sure that you are not going to need that on the barbecue very long at all.
Not at all. Quick, down, and dirty. This goes with a little bit of cornbread, which we have on the outside there. Cornmeal, a little bit of flour, a little bit of sugar, 2 eggs, and baking soda. Such a simple, quick, and easy to do, down and dirty. All
nice.
Right, now you've got that salad there.
I'm done.
Look, let's plate it. I'm going to use the hands because I'm one of those chefs.
Okay, because you're chefy that way.
You know how it is, right?
And
it's got to look good. I took just one of the leaves. I took it off.
Yeah.
So it acts as a nice little stabilizer.
Lovely.
And look what you just did.
I'm amazing that way, aren't I? So you have a beautiful slaw. You call this a Savoy slaw.
Yes, I do.
You have your short ribs that were so super easy and quick.
Yes.
And then the cornbread. Like, I just don't want to glance over the cornbread.
I think
that is huge for me. Actually, for me, that's the meal.
I want
the cornbread.
I do. When I make these guys in the restaurant, I just kill myself because I want to eat most of it before it even gets out to the guests.
Because
we have a salsa night, and I put this on the menu. Oh, it's wonderful.
So good.
Totally nice. And let's see, we still got stuff to do.
This?
Are you going to cook?
I don't know.
Let me let you cook.
What do you want to make now?
No. You're going to make the short ribs now because, all right, listen, you got to start.
Okay, these are Tracy's short ribs now.
All right, Tracy?
Yes.
You take that. I'll hold it for you. You take one out and put it on the grill for me, all right? There you go. Nicely, and put it on a nice super... Oh, look at that.
Just on a diagonal, like yours.
Are you like a grill master already, too? Like, is this what you do in your secret life?
This is what I do
All right, you put those two on. Let's just watch you do this, because I'm always interested to see how other people do what I do naturally.
I learn quickly.
Watch this. Will you watch that, all right? So I'm going to get this. All I want to do now is just take the ribs off the bone.
Okay.
And it's not that difficult. And you can overcook these, but even if you overcook them, it's still not that bad.
Well, and a lot of people do. They prefer that. There are a lot of people out there that want to make sure their meat is like rock hard cooked, like all the way through.
You don't need to.
I don't know, but some people like that, right? Hey, it's up to you. Whatever you like, it's your palate that counts. Now, I love the fact that you're removing the bone, though. So you're not gonna. Well, this can actually be a date meal now. There's no bone.
You don't want to eat that with the bone.
Yeah, no.
There. All right.
It just gets annoying.
It does get annoying, but it's kind of, you know, where the flavor is found. It's found right in the bone.
Now, okay, well, now that we're watching my beautiful short ribs, I'm going to give people some information about how they can get more of Rob Rainford. Are we making a sandwich out of this?
Yeah, I am. You keep going. You keep going.
Okay,
keep going.
All right. Yeah. I like
the
idea of that.
You know,
well, if you love today's segment, guess what? You can get much more of Rob in this book. It's called Born to Grill. We're going to make it easy for you to buy it. What you have to do is go to cityline.ca, click on today's show guide, and you're going to find a buy link. If you're looking for these recipes, we put them all on our website at cityline.ca. You know, treat that special someone in your life to an amazing meal. If you want to do it up in a sandwich, he's adding cheese.
Smoked Gouda.
We'll put the recipe for the sandwich as well on our website. Yes, he's doing it Rob Rainford style. More coming up after the break. Stay with us. Cityline.ca.